It was October of 1988, and the Judicial Executives Worldwide Organization, also known as the Jews, met for their monthly meeting. For the last 2,000 years, this group has orchestrated every single major event on a global scale in order to retain their power. Their first operation occurred in the year 30 AD when they crucified Jesus Christ. Now that Ronald Reagan was out of office, the group was able to get George Bush elected as president. Their latest scheme was to organize the largest terrorist attack in world history, and they were going to use George Bush and his son in order to ensure the plan's success. This attack, of course, was 9/11. The Jews had the plan in place, and now all they had to do was establish a money laundering scheme in order to fund the project. It was decided that they would produce a television program, and because the Jews control the media, they could ensure that the show would be a huge financial success. The Jews appointed one of their most trusted members, Jerry Seinfeld, to run the show. The program was titled Seinfeld. It took place in New York. It ran for 9 seasons, and it was awarded 11 Emmys. Seinfeld, New York, 9/11. The answer was staring us in the face all along. On September 11th, 2001, the plan went off without a hitch. Using the money earned from Seinfeld, the Jews were able to puppeteer George W. Bush into coordinating a false flag terrorist attack on the World Trade Center. This was done for 2 reasons: to destroy incriminating documents stored within the buildings, and to engender the beginning of a worldwide fear of Islam, the greatest enemies of the Jews. Fast forward 5 years later to 2006. The Jews were ready to enact the next phase of their master plan. This master plan, of course, is to create a Jewtopia on another planet, most likely Mars, where every citizen is a member of the Jew organization, and all other humans are treated as slaves. Furthermore, in order to prevent any interference from the humans remaining on Earth, they intend to end all life on Earth. In order to accomplish these goals, the Jews need to do 2 things: encourage the development of space travel, and orchestrate a third world war that would engulf humanity in a nuclear holocaust. Planting the seeds for the Third World War would be easy. All they would need to do is continuously commit radical Islamic terrorist attacks worldwide in order to plant the seeds of conflict on a global scale. By the year 2020, the Western world will engage in war against Islam, and the results, naturally, will result in the end of life on Earth. At the same time, the Jews need to convince people to invest their money and efforts into developing space travel and the ability for human life to thrive on other planets. In order to do this, the Jews developed a hoax known as global warming. They paid thousands of scientists worldwide to lie and say that the Earth's environment was in danger, so that people would become interested in developing societies on other planets in order to escape their doomed planet. The Jews, of course, would take and use these innovations for themselves in order to start their Jewtopia. Their plan, however, didn't work, as the common man was uninterested in the opinions of scientists. That's when the Jews decided they needed a new approach. They needed to create a children's movie with an environmental message that would teach children and adults alike that humanity was responsible for the decline of the Earth's ecosystem. Once again, the Jews put Jerry Seinfeld in charge of the project, and B-Movie was born. We are running out of time. If we don't act fast, then the Jews will get away with their scheme. We will all die in a global nuclear blast as we engage in war against Islam while the Jews watch and laugh from their colony on Mars. Seinfeld and B-movie are evidence of their plans. And if we can expose these truths to the world, then there's a good chance we can stop the Jews before it's too late. I need to warn the world. I need to hit the streets and tell everybody about B-movie.
Hey, buddy. Sorry I was late. What the fuck are you doing?
I've got to warn them about the B-movie. I've got to tell them all about the Jews.
God damn, no, I'm not going to let you do that.
I've got to do it. I've got to do it.
When you started this YouTube channel, I thought it was good for you to have this creative outlet, but it's only made things worse.
Listen to me, because you need to understand this. What that man did to you was wrong. It was very, very wrong. And he's brainwashed you into thinking that it was okay.
And there's some part of you that knows that this is wrong, but it's like your personality is split into two. One day, you're giving a serious review over Elliot Rodger, the next day you fucking think it's some kind of Obama conspiracy!
You're just so confused and angry and desperately want to make sense of a world that for you just doesn't make sense! And this Mumkey shit, it's only making it worse!
This has to stop. I just want Jimmy back. It's time to take the mask off, bud.
Here you go, Jimmy. Put this mask on. I want you to be my little monkey boy.
I don't wanna.
Put it on! That's it. Yes. You look so beautiful. Come with me, monkey. Let me make you some more of my special apple juice. We can watch Boku no Pico together. Let's go. Good girl.
It looks like that accident on Army Post is being cleaned up fairly quickly, so the speed of the traffic should be picking up soon. In other news, investigators have now confirmed that the body of the young woman found this morning is Alyssa Richardson, a 22-year-old ISU student. Her body was found floating in Gray's Lake with multiple stab wounds. Police insist that those planning on visiting the lake do not go alone.
Wild as heart, drop of mind, torn apart, sick in the sky.
Sleep well. I